Well, thanks for staying this long. My name's Eric Rasmussen. I have 5 children, and they've been in Christian school, homeschooled, public schools, English Church of England government schools, and even an English Catholic private school. So I know something of all of these. And different kids are good for different kinds of schools. Like one year we had 2 of my kids homeschooled and the other 2 at LCA, because those 2 children needed extra pushing at home. They wouldn't get at the school. So I think choice is really valuable. I want to comment first, though, on special needs kids. There is special state and federal funding for them. Once Seven Oaks has those kids, it'll have the special needs money. Special needs kids are special. And for that reason, I think it actually makes more sense to wait till you see who you've got and tailor things for them, rather than trying to jam them into some prearranged plan. I think that can be worked out. I teach economics at IU, and actually I'll tell you a story I was telling my class that kind of fits this. It's about Kentucky moving companies. Till this year, Kentucky had a law saying that if you wanted to start a new moving company, you had to obtain what's called a certificate of necessity, showing that it was necessary to have a new moving company because the current moving companies were inadequate. And you had to send emails to all the existing moving companies so they could comment. Naturally, they did, and over a 5-year period, 39 new companies applied, had 117 objections, there were public hearings, 36 of the new entrants gave up in the middle of the hearings, the other 3 persevered and were turned down. Well, last year, this went to federal court, and the federal judge said this violates the Bill of Rights, that this is not a legitimate government purpose to make moving companies rich, and you should allow a little bit more choice. Well, I hear the same sort of thing tonight. The education establishment wants an absolute monopoly for their particular style of public education. They aren't content with 100%, I'm sorry, 95%, they want 100%. I think there are enough parents who would like a different style to at least, and parents and taxpayers, that they compose at least 5% of the community. And I think it's kind of embarrassing, it should be, that you're trying to deny other people even 5% choice. Aren't you embarrassed by intolerance of intellectual diversity? You can talk about the kids at a particular school being diverse, and I'm sure they will be at Seven Oaks too, but the real question is there choice of different ways of thinking, different ways of teaching in the community? Thank you. Amen.